The Esriely Program in Brain, Mind, and Consciousness is a new program at CIFAR, at the Canadian Institute for Advanced Research, which focuses on how the brain gives rise to mind, how it is that 3 pounds of wetware inside our skull gives rise to how we think deeply about the world, how we make decisions, how we create art and enjoy art, all of those kinds of things that are particularly human.
We're starting to close the gap between brain and mind. And one of the great things that we're showing in this program is that, you know, one is directly the product of another. It's not that we have a brain and we have a mind, it's that our brain produces our sense of having a mind. You know, that's very exciting for me because we're really starting to work out exactly where our sense of being us comes from.
We really know very little about how activity in the brain leads to high-level cognition and consciousness. So from a sort of fundamental science perspective, it's also a fascinating question. My view is that once we understand all of these different aspects of easy questions, I think we're going to be much closer to understanding the hard problem, which is how is it, why is it that we experience the world in the way that we do?
I think it's important that we understand how the brain gives rise to mind. In the same way that it's important fundamentally to understand the origin of the universe. It's a kind of deep question, in this case, about human nature, that we really need to understand as curious creatures on this planet.
One of the things that we have managed to do recently is to actually communicate with some patients who are assumed to be vegetative while they're lying in the MRI scanner. Now, to do that was a tremendous technical achievement, I think. We all think about consciousness in different ways, but broadly, when we talk about consciousness, we're thinking about wakefulness, you know, being having your eyes open, being awake, and something like awareness of who we are, where we are. And those two components of consciousness are aspects that we have tried to work out how best to measure.
Clearly, there's the importance of understanding how patients with different kinds of brain damage can be left with different kinds of problems in cognition and memory and sensory processing and motor control and so on. But at the same time, there are lessons that engineers can learn from how the brain works in controlling our complex movements, how the brain works in solving problems. And there are lessons there for engineers, for people working in computer science, for artificial intelligence.
I come from a very applied perspective in some senses. I want to be able to understand how we can treat diseases like Alzheimer's disease. And, you know, Alzheimer's disease is one of the biggest problems facing our society at the moment with our aging population. And I think the only way that we're going to be able to develop effective treatments is to have a fundamental understanding of the brain circuits that are involved in the aspects of cognition that are affected in Alzheimer's disease.
Some point from us being a, you know, a tiny organism made up of a few cells to being a fully grown adult, consciousness emerges at some point along that line. And we have absolutely no idea where does it come from, when does it start to emerge, how does it emerge? And those are the sorts of big questions we are putting to our CIFAR group to say, let's start thinking about this, because this is a practical problem that we should be able to solve.